Alrighty, this is a quick video on how to remove a cannon pinion from a Poggle watch. So the cannon pinion's sitting there on the top, and I bought a tool for this. Normally I use my tweezers, and I pull straight up, which is not recommended because you can bend the top of the pivot of the gear. So I've got a device here, as you see. It's got jaws that you put over the cannon pinion. And then you grip onto the cannon pinion, use a lever, and you push the lever down, and it grabs it and brings it straight up. So what I'll do is try to fit this over the top of the cannon pinion. The problem I have here, though, is that there's jaws on the top. There's sort of jaws inside of a jaw, so I got to kind of wiggle this onto the cannon pinion. And I'm doing this for the very first time, because normally I use my tweezers and deal with it that way. But I'm going to try to lift it up, so get the double jaw thing happening. So just checking out the jaws for a second here. And I put it on top, kind of wiggle it around until it gets on top. And it's kind of neat making a video, and then you say, okay, this is how I'm doing it. It's not perfect. Plus, I got to go golfing in a few minutes, so I need to do this fast before I lose my enthusiasm to go hit some golf balls. So I get that over the top. Now I'm pushing on the lever. Can't see me push the lever, but trust me, I'm pushing down the lever and it grips the cannon pinion. The outside rim of this device has it. And the cannon pinion came right up. It's stuck inside the removal tool. And the center gear just fell through the center. Now, you should really do this as a first step before you disassemble the watch completely, but this time I just disassembled everything, and I still have to disassemble the keyless mechanism. This is a 21 jewel pocket watch too. It's very nice. Anyway, so it's a jaw inside of a jaw, so it's kind of like Alien, where you see the one jaw open and the other jaw's inside there. So it's the Alien cannon pinion remover. So that's how I remove the cannon pinion, and hopefully this tool will last a long, long time. I think I saw this in a catalog from 1890, so this tool has been around a very long time. Maybe that's my video on how to remove the cannon pinion. There's a center gear that kind of dropped, and again, you got to do this before you disassemble the watch. Thanks for watching the video, and it's quick and dirty, but there you go. Thanks a lot.